Imagine your paper as a supporting wall of a building. The wall is made up of many bricks. Each paragraph of your paper is like an individual brick in that wall. Just like each individual brick bears weight and contributes to the stability of the wall, each paragraph of your paper contributes to the overall effectiveness of your argument and helps get your point across. As a writer, you must take care in how you construct your paragraphs. In fact, you can think of each paragraph as a kind of micro paper. If a paper is a collection of paragraphs, a paragraph is a collection of sentences dealing with a single topic. Just like there are basic elements of a paper, there are basic elements of a paragraph. These elements include unity, coherence, a topic sentence, and adequate development. But before we talk about these elements, let's first review some basics about the building block of a paragraph, the sentence. Okay, I know this is pretty basic, but it's worth a quick review. So what is a sentence? It is a group of words that makes a complete thought and contains a subject and predicate. The subject tells what or who the sentence is about and always contains a noun or pronoun. The predicate always contains a verb and tells what the subject is doing or being. Remember, there are two types of verbs. Action verbs, such as jump, write, think, research, and analyze. And being verbs, such as am, be, is, was, and seem. A sentence is made up of one or more clauses. A clause is a collection of words that contains a verb and a predicate, but is not necessarily a sentence. A clause that can stand alone is an independent clause. All sentences are independent clauses. Dependent clauses cannot stand alone. Dependent clauses do not express complete thoughts. When used in sentences, they are often separated by a comma. Dependent clauses often are marked with or start with words like after, although, as if, because, before, even if, even though, if, in order to, since, though, unless, until, whatever, when, whenever, whether, or while. The next video in this series will provide more discussion about sentence structure, grammar, punctuation, and other important writing mechanics. However, how you write your sentences is crucial to developing good paragraphs. Remember, your sentences should typically consist of a complete thought, have a well-defined subject, and a predicate. Each time you write a sentence, make sure that you have at least satisfied these three requirements. Now, let's get back to talking about paragraphs. Probably the basic rule of writing a paragraph is one idea, one paragraph. A paragraph should focus on only one idea or concept. Unity is the defining aspect of a paragraph. Your paragraph may contain several points, just as long as they are directly related to one main idea. If you are presenting many points, or the points contain a lot of detail, you may separate these points into their own individual paragraphs. To enhance unity, all paragraphs should contain a topic sentence. A topic sentence essentially tells the reader what the paragraph is about. A topic sentence can appear anywhere in a paragraph, but if you have just started writing papers, it is probably a good idea to place your topic sentence near the beginning of the paragraph. This insect is able to stand on the surface of pond water because of water's property of coherence. Coherence is the property of sticking together. It is not enough that a paragraph only has unity. Its contents must logically and smoothly flow together. A coherent paragraph is more understandable and more easily read. You should strive for paragraph coherence by using some common words and phrases that link concepts to one another. Some common connectors include, for example, for instance, first, second, third, as another example, finally, in conclusion, to summarize, on one hand, however, but, and also. A paragraph is typically described as a collection of four or more related sentences. The number four is not arbitrarily made. The paragraph topic, as defined by the topic sentence, must be adequately developed. Depending on the topic, it is probably not possible to adequately develop a topic in less than four sentences. You can develop your paragraph topic in several ways. Common ways include the use of examples and illustrations, citing of data, facts, and statistics, using an anecdote or story, defining terms, comparing and contrasting, evaluating causes and reasons, analyzing the topic, and providing a chronology. So the elements of a sound paragraph include the presence of unity, a topic sentence, coherence, and adequate development. Let's take a look at these elements in action. Remember that paper on professional sports' impact on American society? Here's a potential paragraph within the body of that paper.
It is clear that professional sports can have a significant impact on the goals and aspirations of young men and may foster unrealistic expectations. The allure of fast money, beautiful women, and playing ball for a living seems fairly irresistible. The recent study of African American high school athletes revealed that 66% believed they had a good chance of making it to the professional sports level. Johnson, 2008. Whereas no one advocates discouraging these young men from pursuing athletic excellence, such pursuits must be undertaken with a clear appreciation of reality. Consider these numbers. At any given time, there are a total of 450 NBA players, 1,696 NFL players, and 1,280 MLB players. Todman, 2010. That means that major U.S. professional sports consist of less than 3,500 players. However, when comparing those numbers with 30,000 African American physicians, 20,000 African American lawyers, and a similar number of African American engineers, it is crucial that young athletes, while pursuing their athletic dreams, prepare for a future that does not include professional sports.
Okay, the first sentence in this paragraph is indeed the topic sentence. Therefore, the balance of the paragraph should focus on professional sports' impact on young men's goals and aspirations. In an effort to adequately develop the topic, the writer uses statistics, data, comparisons, and research citations. Further, the use of the words whereas and however contribute to coherence by connecting concepts. This paragraph presents with well-written sentences unified by a central theme, supported and developed with research and statistics, and held together with key connecting words and the writer's effort to address a single topic. If you strive to include these elements in each paragraph you write, you will be well on your way to becoming an effective writer and earning that great grade.